Welcome to Hopkinton Coffee Break, your home for current community talk with Patricia Duart, Darlene Hayes, and Connie Wright.
Welcome to our coffee break. Just us girls today.
Veterans Day.
Veterans Day, absolutely. And salute to all the veterans and all the folks who are
tomorrow night
still out there.
Is the dinner for the veterans at the Woodville Rod and Gun Club.
Yes.
Oh, and then start with a breakfast and great celebration.
The breakfast is at the Senior Center.
Okay.
And if they're actually looking for help with the breakfast. It probably is filled by the time this airs, mm-hmm. but people want to drop off munchkins or things. You can drop them off by 10 o'clock tomorrow morning, which you're
dropping
seeing this at
8
o'clock. Things like munchkins or little muffins at the
munchkins.
Breakfast or things like that for the veterans.
Edibles, not the children.
Yeah. But the they do a really nice job of it.
I was going to say, Hopkinton just really puts its arms around veterans, you know, and the different events that are held every year. So it's a really sweet remembrance.
I'm baking cookies.
That same weekend is also a Gold Star family dinner that I think takes place in Milford.
Wow.
And you know, how impactful, like, when you hear some of their stories. I know the woman next door to me was a Gold Star mother for years, and how never getting over it.
Right. And for those of you, Gold Star is...
Please, just remind what that means.
You've lost a child or a sibling in war.
Or a spouse.
Okay. You know, I never heard that term until recently, honestly, Gold Star. I mean, I'm thinking about, you know, my father's era from the Korean War or even World War II. Did they always use the term Gold Star family?
Yeah.
Somehow it just, with the hullabaloo of late around the, you know...
Yep.
Issues nationally about Gold Star.
It's been brought up.
It's been brought up, but I never heard that reference, Gold Star, before then.
Veterans Day is also kind of cool for me because it's my anniversary.
Right. And stuff. November's a big month for you in general.
November birthday just was a couple weeks ago.
November's
belated happy birthday, Darlene.
November's a very unique month for our family. Between both sides, 25 out of the 30 days we have birthdays.
No way.
Wow.
We've actually had November birthday parties. I actually, like...
We're April. My family's April.
On my actual birthday, our godson, Josh, who just turned 11, we share the same day, but then know that, like, my day alone, I know four people with the same birthday.
Nice.
Marie that works at TJ's and everything else, we share a birthday. Josh, Ellen Rutter's boyfriend has the same birthday as me.
That's funny.
You know, Lisa Stuckel's son, Cole, and stuff. But... Literally, it's like cousin or friend or like stuff like that.
So November's your busy month.
November is a busy month. I mean, it's, you know, my best friend Holly, this year, her birthday falls on Thanksgiving.
Oh, wow.
And stuff like that. So, and they're split. They're Scorpios and Sagittarius.
Yeah. I wonder if anybody ever did statistics on the numbers of people born in November. In our family, my daughter's birthday is November.
Valentine's Day,
my grandmother had a Thanksgiving birthday. My father-in-law had a Thanksgiving birthday. The rest of us are summer and fall.
So my son was born on Thanksgiving.
And I have to tell you, I laugh because in my family, April's the birthday month. And I have sister-in-laws and brother-in-laws and children and nephews and nieces and great nieces, you know, and April's our big birthday month. And I know a lot of people with birthdays on or in around my birthday. Yep. And so that's weird. I don't know.
Kira, my daughter, always says, you know, in terms of her birthday month, she doesn't like the weather typically in November or the birthstone ring.
No. April takes the cake. You know what the birthstone ring is?
Isn't it diamond?
No. Exactly.
What's wrong with that?
Because you're not going to wear a diamond ring.
Why not?
Well, unless it's an engagement ring.
If you put a diamond
on the other hand,
of course you can wear diamonds anywhere.
I get topaz, for God's sakes. You get diamond.
Right. I have sapphire, which I love.
Ooh, I like sapphire. September.
I love sapphire.
I do like the blue.
That's Sean's birthday, and
But the November is topaz. But it can be yellow.
It can be gold, blue, or almost opaque, almost like a diamond. You can get it like double.
Yeah, it's
gold.
Yeah,
it's like a gold color.
Yeah. You like topaz?
I like the blue topaz, but I only like it in earrings. I don't like to wear it on my hands or anything.
But you see, I'm ring less these days.
me too. No hints. Sorry.
Caffeinated.
Let's go. Let's go back to it's Veterans Day.
Well,
officially, tomorrow, Saturday, but the government holiday is today, so schools are off, et cetera, et cetera. The big thing's happening.
It just has felt like gala season. I've just been getting off of all these fun events. The rhythms of traditions in Hopkinton are just fun.
Well, I mean, there's traditionally two gala seasons. There's, the October, November, and then there's March, April.
Yes. Right.
And,
the locally, event planning pro
we've
over here.
Had more here locally in the November.
We're actually pretty evenly split.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, the country club's event, the HEF are all spring
HEF
events.
For spring.
And,
HEF,
HEF has been like the adult prom for many years.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I think when you think of like the library had a gala, a few weeks ago, but that's a one-off.
I hope they still have their fun fundraisers.
Oktoberfest. Yeah. Well, yeah.
They said they were going to stop, I guess, after the gala, the successful opening and so forth. But I love their fun things at St. John's, Pink Night and Oktoberfest.
Yeah.
Just to keep some stuff going just
for
the fun of it.
They're a huge amount of work, too.
I know.
And, their goal was to raise $1 million, and surpassing that for the library was huge. I mean, I think, yes, there's going to be future fundraisers and things like that.
Yeah.
I don't know if they'll go to the same extent. I know there are other organizations that actually want to take over Oktoberfest and things like that, too.
Yeah, that's true.
And so it's a chance to spread the wealth of ideas and things like that because, we're not reinventing the wheel, and we're all dipping into the same donors, same residents.
So that's true. That's true.
So, but you were saying, that, darling, that there may be some attempt to coordinate calendars around the various organizations around town.
I think that'd be very important.
I think that's still kind of quietly being kind of reached out. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think in January, there's a group of us that are going to meet and kind of discuss some ideas like coordinating some, nonprofit outreach and some of and having a couple of nonprofits take the lead and some coordination, but the meeting hasn't even happened yet.
Yeah.
It's very premature.
Yeah.
Well, and I think long run, yes, it'll happen. I think it's going to take, a very strategic plan.
So groups know. I mean, they can choose, I'm sure, whatever date they want, but they'll be aware of what they're
doing. Well, case in point, all the 5Ks and things that happen, and when you have one on a Saturday and the next one on a Sunday and it's the same runners, so to be able to be generous and supportive, and because we're a running town, we're the start of the marathon, so a lot of organizations want them to happen here, even if the organization, many of them are homegrown from here.
And some don't have to start here. I mean, like the Metro SY did theirs in Ashland.
And
actually they started where the original marathon started. Mm-hmm. But I think, we're still very premature in getting a calendar or any sort of organization or the umbrella that would do that.
Right.
So I'd rather, let's talk about this in February or March after we've had a couple meetings.
No, just the idea.
Well, we went a couple weeks ago to the Y, I hate to call it gala, the YMCA. They had some fun auction items. And one of the ones that you and I found interesting, because it appeals to both the youth and the adults, and I'm like, brilliant, was the Framingham Fire Station will cook you a dinner, and then they coupled it with free photography.
For six people.
Six
at the fire station.
And one group was with kids, and the other one was with adults because they wanted to slide down the pole, have pictures taken with the firemen, and it was just like hilarious.
Right.
Like,
but what a fun, ingenious idea for fundraising.
Yeah, I thought that was great. I hadn't heard of that one before.
I know. Well, no, that was a great event, too. And they do a wonderful thing with silent auction, well supported throughout.
Another one I was at recently was for the Charles River Watershed Association.
Yes.
And that took place at the Museum of Science.
Ooh.
And, a lot of people don't realize is that, the Charles River Watershed Association is a very deeply rooted that is based in science on protecting the Charles River, cleaning it up. And the Charles River has now become the cleanest river in the country.
Yeah.
But, the Charles River starts in Hopkinton.
Here.
And parts of it, blend into where it's part of the Sudbury River and parts of it have different names, but it is here.
Right.
And so, there was a wing added into the Museum of Science that was revealed at this event at the Yawkey Gateway. For the Charles River. So it has a little piece about Hopkinton, little pieces about this, but it shows kind of the transition of the cleanup of everything. And it's actually right after the registration desk at the at the Museum of Science. You go right downstairs, and it's right along. It's inside, but right along the water.
Wow. Yeah.
And it shows a lot of what's going on. And the reveal was at that gala, so no one had seen it before. It was kind of cool to get a glimpse
of it. And a lot of people don't know that the Charles River does start, indeed, right here.
And where is that exactly? Do you know?
So I think
it's over
going down Hayden Row and behind EMC Park. It's marshy. It's watery. It's not like, you know. But that's the spring water source.
It runs behind my parents' house in Ashland. I mean, I played at it growing up. I mean, it's literally in our yard. Mm-hmm. And, you know, my nephew that I said that we share a birthday, it runs right through his yard in Medway. Mm-hmm. And so Michael
it really meanders around.
And his brother did a thing where they, they launched a canoe in Medway to do the entire Charles River. And there were only one place where they had to, like, actually take out of water and come up. And that was in South Natick, where they have the stairs you had to go up and down.
Oh, wow.
And stuff. And, you know, the two wives are, like, on either end, like, all right, where are they now? But,
yeah, you can.
They actually canoed the entire length. And, you know, I picked them up by the Newton Boathouse.
Cool. Yeah. Well, you know, all these little back tributaries and so forth, which you wouldn't be familiar with unless you really studied it or knew about it. I'm excited about the Running Club's event coming up.
I
think it's December 2nd. And they have I'm excited, and I'm not a runner, but it makes me want to maybe figure out how to get out there and walk it or something. It's 10 miles.
10K.
No.
So 10K, 6.2 miles.
Yes.
Sorry about
that's
that.
That's all right.
But I love it that you're going. It's not in town. It's weaving around
Whitehall
through, and you said it's not backwoods trails. It's really streets. And
they're going down Spring Street and Winter Street.
Trails.
And they're going to go through, you know, Victory Field. They'll go through Reed Park. And they're going to have a beer tent at the end. Start line is...
That sounds fun. Stay warm trying to walk 6 miles,
and
run 6 miles.
It's actually kind of a tradition with a lot of runs now that you end at a beer tent. You toast off and stuff like that. So... you know, they pulled a, you know, one day event liquor license and stuff like that.
Sounds fun.
But when we talk about events coming up, you know, one day, 1 month from today is Shopping for the Cause.
That's right.
This will be the fourth year that we've done this.
Yes. RHH's annual charitable event where we have vendors from around Hopkinton and beyond. This year, we're partnering with HCA, so we are combining what they had done in previous years.
Holiday Boutique.
Is combined with RHH's Shopping for the Cause. So we'll have juried artisans as well as vendors that have been really popular with our event.
And
that'd be a blast.
The vendor component is almost sold out, so if you want to be a vendor,
get
on there.
Right away. Yeah.
I think we may have a few sponsor slots open, but that's even almost sold out. And we're getting close, and I know it's a month away, but... Buy your tickets for the event
there's complimentary wine.
Complimentary
nibbles and wine.
We have
like that.
Never. Everybody has gone away, eaten and consumed as much as they've wanted to. So
and shopped.
In moderation.
Of course.
And stuff like that.
It's not open bar. We're talking about a little bit.
Yeah, you know, we do small pours of wine and stuff like that.
Just little taste.
But people have a good time shopping. Last year was kind of neat, and it was the first year that I saw some people bring their daughters with them to shop.
Yes.
And they were giving. We used to do it on a weeknight, and it was too much of a school night and things like that. Moving it to a Sunday, I know two of my friends brought their daughters. Mm-hmm. They each gave them, you know, one gave them $50, one gave them like $20. Go buy little odds and ends, and it was kind of neat because they were like. Can you hide this under the table for me? It's my mom's Christmas present.
It's great to get a head start on your Christmas shopping, your holiday shopping.
You know, I want to do a shout out to Trina Mackey of Sotheby because she has raised her hand every year to be the presenting sponsor of this.
Yeah.
And really been like an anchor of this event,
Without hesitation.
And, you know, the Chamber of Commerce has been very involved. And this year they're actually getting more involved. They want people to get involved in the chamber, know who they are.
So
they'll actually have a table there talking about who they are, membership benefits, and stuff like that.
We're looking forward to everyone being there, grateful to the vendors, and looking forward to the proceeds going to
HCA.
Actually, you're wearing something from one of the vendors right here.
The confidence. What?
And she's actually been a vendor every single year.
Linda Waters, confidence.
And I actually, I'm holding off. There's two things I want to get, and I can't wait to see her. So I'm like, Okay. A gift from my mom, a gift from my daughter. I get my daughter a gift from her every year, but now I'm like, I got to get my mom something.
Well, at our event.
I think the neat thing is to see that these, yes, a lot of the vendors want to come back. They've had a good time that's been successful for them.
They have as much fun as the shoppers
And they get a couple samplings of, you know, appetizers and beverages. They enjoy it. And a couple of them have actually built some partnerships through it. Mm-hmm. We had, you know, a young woman who makes scarves, a young woman who's made hair bows, and they've actually combined efforts on other shows later on and stuff like that. So it's been kind of neat to see some of the relationships that have built from it, you know, and people come in to, you know, have a good time, have a little bit of shopping.
A little holiday cheer. It's just such a nice vibe. Beautiful space.
Well,
awesome.
It's also this time of year, and a shout out to all of our seniors in the high school. This is college. You're pulling your college applications together. You've got about a month and change to go. And I know it's tough. You got a senior.
We're done.
You were done. Right.
Yeah. So we're done weeks ago.
That's her applications are out. And you know,
I mean, she only had a couple. She was, you know, we looked at a bunch. She narrowed it down, and that was it.
Well, and I have to tell you, I am the tail. I have three children, and my three kids all did it differently. And I had really early, kind of middling, and then one that my December was, it's like, oh, my God.
We're also doing early decisions, so it's like, we're hoping before Christmas, and
it's
we hope
December 15th is
so we're hoping we know before Christmas, and it's done. Wow. She can open a Christmas present with a sweatshirt from wherever it is.
But it's hard. And you know, I do the alumni interviews for my alma mater every year, and the early actual ones are happening. They it's a hard stop for early decision for most schools right before Thanksgiving for the interviews, and then they try to let everybody know by December 15th or so. But it's just busy, and these kids are so busy. A couple of the interviews are like, oh, we're in the playoffs, and you know, our high school sports teams have been rocking it.
I mean, I think it's more emotionally overwhelming for the parents the first time they're going through it, too. I mean, this is my second time, so it wasn't as hard. Melissa kind of had a grasp on where the range of region she wanted to be in. She very much knew kind of what she wants to study in some ways, so we narrowed it down before even going out. You know, I have a friend whose daughter is brilliant, and I know you watch, so you went to 42 schools.
You've applied,
and I know you see this, so you went to 40, to the point that it's become so overwhelming. And I mean, we've had some really good resources. I know, like, Christine Chapman, who we've had on the show, and has been an RH community supporter ongoing for the last couple of years. She sat down with Melissa, helped her with her essay. I know she sat down with the one who went to 42 schools to narrow her down to 14 schools to apply to.
Apply that.
No, she didn't apply. They went and visited. They literally drove up and down the East Coast to 42.
But bear in mind, you know,
Everyone does it their own way.
Well, and clearly, even though my baby graduated from college a year ago, so let's, you know, clearly it's imprinted on my brain, the storm and drawing and drama, we did a lot of college fairs. So maybe we didn't get to 42 schools, but I can tell you with each kid, and of course my boys, kind of my middle son, got kind of the short shift because he had to tag along with his brother on a lot of schools, and he had a completely different academic focus. So then we had to do a few more just for him.
We thought that whole college tour was fun. We enjoyed it. You know, I kind of look back and smile when I think about you and other parents whose kids are still going through it. I'm also happy to be on the other side of it, where, you know, they're done with college.
You don't have a tuition bill.
Don't have a tuition bill.
Next year we'll have two tuition bills. So
gave myself a raise when they graduate.
So my only, you know, insight about college kids anymore is just through my client work. So I'm doing work with WPI and UMass and so forth. And I love just the whole energy, you know, but because I'm so past it in my personal life.
And when I do the interviews, and I have to say, really, for most of the kids, it's not if you're going to college, it's that you're going to college. It's not where you get in, it's what you do when you get there.
Mm-hmm.
And so, you know, I mean, oh, by the way, college isn't always right for everybody. And oh, by the way, even if your child should go to college, maybe a year off, a gap year, doing other things, we all take different paths, and we have all different routes in life. And You just want to help your child to be exactly. a healthy, independent adult and get them on the road to becoming that. So
the best launching pad, and it's, you know, interesting, I mean, 5 years after college and certainly beyond that, no one's even thinking or talking about transcripts or any of it. It's what,
oh, God.
What can you do? What is your work experience? How
yep.
do you come, how do you show up in terms of performance
yep.
And so forth?
So true.
It
so
becomes
true.
Just something for the resume and,
yep.
you know, exactly. Yeah. But your oldest will be, how? What year is he in? In college at Maryland?
Well, right now he's a junior. And then after his winter co-op, and the Maritime Academy has a very long winter break. So either you're going out on sea term, you've got some sort of excursion, like, you know, his freshman year he had to go to St. John's for 3 weeks, like
right.
real rough.
Had to go to
right.
St. John's.
Oh, that was before.
Yeah, and we got to pay for it, which was awesome. And we pay for the co-ops, too.
I know.
But the, because they're getting credit for it. Mm-hmm. But, you know, he'll have a winter co-op, and then when they don't go back till the first week in March. But they don't mm-hmm. get, most colleges are out the first week in May. They're out the third week in June.
Oh, okay.
I mean, actually, Hopkinton High School is out before the Maritime Academy.
Wow.
He will go back in March as a senior.
That's cool.
So he'll
excellent.
Have,
he's worked
wow.
that hard. Congratulations.
You know, and then he'll have a summer co-op, and then he'll have the fall as a second semester senior. I'm not letting him take his diploma early because I want the graduation the following June. So even like
that's fine.
Even
yeah.
like we just ordered his
pump and circumstance.
His ring was just ordered this past week, and he's like, well, do I put, you know, December 18 on it or June 19? I'm like, you put June 19th of the
oh.
19 on it.
I did
and
the
he,
same
thing.
I graduated early, but I did
and,
the.
Regular. And they do a very yeah. big deal on a rings
it's more
there
fun.
Because it's a merchant marine
yeah.
school. So that the ships have gone to all the different seas,
mm-hmm.
so they keep they must have a dirty bucket of water somewhere. But mm-hmm. the water is representative of the seven seas.
Oh,
so they do a chalice, and before you can wear your ring, your
you
ring is
blessed.
It's dipped into this thing of the seven seas.
Traditions and ceremonies.
But oh no, I want the white uniform and whatever swords and like
oh
circumstance
God.
They have with that after like 4 years of getting this boy through.
I'm glad my parents didn't care. I didn't even do the walk. I was already working and was busy.
So was
and
I. But
I was a city kid commuting to the yeah. University of Cincinnati. So I don't know. It just didn't feel. So I really wanted. That all experience for my kids, and we did all that,
good.
And it was fun.
Good.
Absolutely,
good. So,
yeah.
I mean, I know my college. It was like a couple days of ceremony.
Oh, it was because my school was huge, so it was they won't miss me if I'm not walking.
I mean, I went to a parochial college, mm-hmm. so the day before was, you know, a hooded mass and all that, and then the next day you get the sashes and everything like that. But it was 2 to 3 days of things. They had, like, you know, reception dinners
oh, yeah.
and lunches and things by your mate. So it felt like a whole week of celebration, but I know it was really like 2 days of really event.
I went to my college within the university's gathering, but, and you know, with the people that I knew and the professors and so forth. But the big thing, you know, I was busy doing something else.
I was going to say, and
yeah.
I went to a large school, so
yeah.
we had the university. But then we had our department
yeah.
graduation, and then, of course, you had all your friends' parties.
I remember being there because I was a liberal arts major, and, you know, even then people were going, oh, what are you going to do with that? But I was already working for a marketing research company, was all in it, and I'm like, I don't know, but I'm good. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. So we talked about tomorrow, the veterans' breakfast, and then the dinner. But what's going on around town?
The same weekend is also Little Monsters, which
yeah.
is the youth production for Interstage Leth, mm-hmm. which is the theater company of HCA. These are, I believe, like first through sixth
oh.
graders. And they do a really, ESL puts a great productions out.
Oh, yeah.
And then next weekend is also the productions at the high school for Seussical. And that's actually a wicked, wicked fun show. If you haven't seen
at the high school
anywhere,
yeah.
it's mm-hmm. it's a colorful, bright, very
cheery,
very fast-paced show.
Okay,
and
as in Dr. Seuss. Seussical.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
It's
that's
very
the
fast-paced
weekend right
show.
Before Thanksgiving is so early this year, so that's the weekend right before Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
So if you've got early family coming in or looking for something to do, great.
No, are you guys hosting Thanksgiving?
I'm hosting, although for the first time, and I don't want to jinx myself, but my daughter and her boyfriend will be coming, and our son, although has a conflict, his girlfriend wants him going to a family wedding on their side. And I'm
on Thanksgiving?
Well, it's Wednesday. This person's having their wedding on Wednesday, which is sort of
the worst
annoying.
Travel day of the year.
Sorry? Yeah.
The worst travel day
I
of the year.
I had a good friend who got married Friday of Thanksgiving week.
And I mean, I can see
the
why.
The Friday of Thanksgiving, that is like the traditional reunion.
Yeah.
Day.
The wedding was out of town, so you all had to travel.
Exactly.
And we're like not going to travel Thanksgiving Day.
And the prices are through the roof.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, fortunately, they can do anyway, they can drive.
Right, but
so I'm saying, well, Evan, why doesn't she just go to the wedding and you
do
things? I'm sounding like that. You know.
I got to tell you, I have started years ago with particularly my boys. With girlfriends, doing Christmases and Thanksgivings.
So you've already had the not everybody there.
Yeah.
This might be our first year, but I don't want to say. Maybe he'll figure it out.
This year, I am going to my mom's in Florida, so I'm doing a holiday, and all three of my kids are going to be there.
That's
so I can't complain this year, Thanksgiving. I won't have them for Christmas, but I am going to have them for Thanksgiving. And we're going to be at my mom's, who's 92.
We're already doing the
list of goodies, but we'll talk about that the week before.
We'll talk about things. What are you doing? Guesting, hosting?
I mean, I usually host all the holidays. I mean, Thanksgiving is actually one of the ones that's smaller at our house.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, meaning that like Christmas Eve, I have like 40 people in and out of my house, and that's enormous for me. But I think there would probably be about 12 of us. Yeah. So it's not that big, and it's
Well, next time we sit down, we're going to talk food and recipes and
prep. Oh, my God. And you know me.
Yeah, I know. We're all in the
Tart
kitchen.
Wench.
All right.
Cheers. Okay. Happy Veterans Day,
guys.
See you guys.
Hey, happy anniversary to me.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes. Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary.
Together, we can change the news. Find out how at safekids.org.
Everyone affected by disasters needs relief. Donations provide a bridge to recovery. People affected by disasters need water, clothing, shelter, and other essentials. But when donating, one size doesn't fit the big, small, and in between. With cash, you can help fill more needs due to no shipping costs or storage fees. Donate smart, donate cash. Money is the only true one-size-fits-all.